What was the strangest moment in your life that you still can't explain up to this day? I was T-boned in an intersection. Not a very serious accident. Mostly just shaken up. I was out of state at college at the time. Minutes after the accident, my cell phone rang, and it was my dad. He said all of a sudden he was consumed with an overwhelming urge to call me. And was everything okay? I told him I was in an accident. He has passed away since, but he and I always had a very strong connection. I wish he would call me now. But then I guess it would be the strangest moment. Kinda similar. My dad passed away on a Sunday morning. While at the mortuary, a person that we worked with called. My dad and I ran a business together. He just asked if everything was alright, and I told him what happened. It was so strange he would call on a Sunday and ask that question. I spent a night a bit drunk with some friends sketching and sharing new ideas for an art project we were working on. We talked a lot about using a fire extinguisher filled with paint for a background effect on huge canvas or a full room. But we're wondering where we could get one for cheap and if it would work as we expected. Around 5 AM I leave my friend's apartment to take the first subway home, and I guess you not. Two streets further on my way, and in the middle of the sidewalk there is a fucking empty fire extinguisher. Took it home. It was such a strange coincidence. Since I never stumbled upon an empty fire extinguisher in the street at any other point in my life, I was pretty sure I dreamt about it when I woke up later. But nope. It was still in the corner of my bedroom. Ever use it for the art idea? Seems like a cool concept. This one time, when I was little, my dad woke me up at like 2 AM, and he said, "Get ready. We are going to McDonald's." I was so fucking confused, and kept asking why, but he wouldn't answer anything besides, "Because ought to have fun." The rest of my family, two brothers, sister, and mom, didn't come with, and I like they were still asleep when we left. The play place was closed, and we just kinda sat there for an hour or so eating, then went back home. To this day, I still have no idea why he frantically needed me out of the house, and he swears he doesn't remember that happening. But the whole thing was so weird that I kept the toy that I got from the Happy Meal to remember it by. That I still have it to this day, because it's my only proof of this weird fucking night that my dad almost scarily hurried me to McDonald's at 2 AM. I have two thoughts. My sister rests the bed and they were worried I'd make fun of her. Maybe they somehow noticed like rats or something in my room. But were worried I wouldn't be able to sleep if I knew that there were rats and they needed an hour or so to get it out. Either way, very strange night that my dad refuses to tell me the truth about. Which only makes me think it's something much worse. Like, I'm 23 now. If you said yeah, her sister rests the bed and we didn't want you to know, I'd have been like cool 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 nice good thinking lol. But he refuses to believe that it happened. What happened? I saw my doppelganger while driving in a parking lot. We passed each other going super slow and made eye contact. We both started laughing and then continued on. My wife was sitting in the passenger seat and saw him as well. It was super weird and really fun for whatever reason. We still talk about it 10 years later. I regret not stopping and finding the guy to take a photo together. I saw Santa driving one day, and I was so giddy from it my husband thought I was crazy for being so happy. It was like October or something, and this guy was dressed up in a good quality suit, and he had a real beard and everything. It was amazing. You know what? I live in Vancouver, Canada. I bet UB was filming something in the area. When I was 7 or 8, I used to spend Friday nights at my grandma's house, and she spoiled the crap out of me. So I loved it. One night, though, I suddenly had a strange urge to call my mom. I dialed my phone number, I mean I knew my own number right. A woman answered. And I suddenly blurted out, "Mom, come and get me." I have no idea why. To this day, that came out of my mouth. Like I said, I loved it there. And up until that moment had no thoughts of being picked up. Anyways, the person on the other end starts to sound panicky and says, "Where are you?" It hits me that this isn't my mom. So I just hang up and go back to watching TV. So weird. And while it seems so minor, it stuck with me for 30 plus years. That mom definition went and found her daughter after you hung up. And that's probably why that happened to you. I was at a gas station and just finished buying something from inside. I came out, and a burly man with a t-shirt that had some sort of meat business on it came up to me asking if I was interested in purchasing bulk frozen meats. I was absolutely broke except for about $500 on my credit card available. I didn't want to buy anything but my mouth blurted out yes, as if my life depended on it. A few minutes later I went home with a month's worth of vacuum sealed fish and chicken. I don't know what said yes, but it wasn't me. Did he ask, "Are you interested in purchasing bulk frozen meats?" Or did he vaguely wave his hand in front of you and say you are interested in purchasing bulk frozen meats like, you know, a GD? GD would make the best salesman. I had a dream once, and within the next month, everything from that dream happened in real life. For example, in the dream my wife rearranged our room, which is weird because she hates rearranging stuff, and then the next week she arranged it exactly like dream. In the dream I also got promoted, and then less than a week later I did in real life. Can you dream for me, friend? I also need my furniture rearranged, if you know what I mean. My mom was looking at an old photo album and talking about a party that she organized for her coworkers more than 25 years ago. She said that it was nice of me to have helped her there setting up the tables, etc. I have zero recollection of that party. Nothing. So I thought she was joking. Then she showed me the pictures and I'm there. WTF. It's not like I was a kid. I was maybe 19 or 20. I wonder what else my brain erased. Not trying to be that guy, but missing memories like that can be a sign of trauma or memory repression. If your brain gets good at erasing s when you're a kid, it starts doing it to lesser and lesser traumas. This explains a lot about my s memory. I was at work several years ago, and a coworker s had a massive seizure. He later told us he had never had one before. Everyone started freaking out, and a man came over and gently held S down because he was in danger of slamming into a desk. When the seizure passed, the man stood up and said ambulance should be here soon. So my work is done and left. The weird thing. Nobody had any idea who that guy was. We were also concerned about S, that we didn't really register that the guy was a stranger until S was taken to the hospital. We were in a building that required a keycard to enter, and it was closed to the general public. There were only 12 of us in that office, and he wasn't one of us. So who the hell was he? Guardian angel? Time traveler? Janitor? A time traveling janitor that does guardian angel stuff part time. After I totaled my car, a man with burn scars all over his face and hands came to my window. He asked if I was okay, and then came and sat in the passenger seat. He said, "I need you to know that everything happens for a reason." I said, "I know." The next thing I know, I'm talking to the other driver and police, and the guy is just gone. No one else saw him. Anything out of the ordinary or things that changed your life's trajectory happened since that day? Until that morning I had been resentful and angry about a lot of things that were beyond anyone's control. When he said that, something inside me shifted. It instantly became my personal truth. That morning sparked an insane series of events that led to me producing an album with my favorite singer, healing my relationship with my mom before she died, and meeting my soulmate. I wasn't his. But it's okay. Everything happens for a reason. I was walking home one day, and when I passed this one old dude's house, and his dog was outside, and when I walked past I could have sworn the dog told me to get the F off the property in perfect English. "You there, swine. Abandon the premises." There is a good chance this was the dog. https://www.youtube.com/watch.v=83m261l. My parents are asleep, and I almost just woke them up laughing at that, then replayed it 11 times. I told work I had to go out of town for a week for a family member's, my grandmother's cousin in Texas, funeral. Completely fictitious. In reality, I just wanted time off to hang out at the luxury home my friend was house sitting. Hot tub, full bar, etc. The day my vacation started, I got a call that my grandmother's cousin passed away, and they were going out of town for the funeral and expected me to go with them. This is why I will never ever use a fake death as an excuse for trying to get out of something. I normally wouldn't. But death was pretty much the only excuse this job would accept. I honestly didn't even know she had a cousin in Texas. I made someone up specifically cause I was afraid to use someone real for a fake funeral. I did that because I didn't want to jinx anyone. After that incident though, I always just say family emergency if I need to give a reason. Less specific. Less chance of someone dying. Friends and I in my shitty Mazda smoking weed in the alley behind my GFS house. Neighbor walks out and starts punching an electric pole until his hands look like hamburger meat and there is blood soaking his white shirt. He calmly walks back into his house. We uncalmly get the F out of there. Lol. He was asserting dominance. When I was very young, we were visiting my grandmother in another city. We slept in the same bed, in the basement. I woke up and saw a person, too dark to be recognizable, enter the room and come to our bed. They looked at us for a while and then left. The next morning, nobody had any idea what I was talking about. I guess it could have been sleep paralysis. But I didn't wake up in a panic. I just watched it happen. Frightened. I had sleep paralysis 4 years and that's exactly what it was like. My brain felt awake, but my body wouldn't move. It's very common to see dark slash shadowy figures. I'd put my bet on sleep paralysis, but that doesn't make it any less creepy or terrifying when you experience it. When I was very little, I remember one night waking up but not really. I tried to open my eyes, but it was like they were held shut by spider webs. I could barely see the ceiling through them. I lay like that for what felt literally like years. Another weird thing was I had a bed shark that would swim under my bed sheet and occasionally I could feel its dorsal fin poke my sides. The only thing I can think of was I had muscle spasms, but it felt just like something sweeping past me side. When I was in my teens, my dad relapsed into his drug and alcohol addiction again. It was the last straw for my mom and I, and we took off in the car at night to go for a drive and get out of the house. We were both angrier than we'd ever been. As we drove down the street, each street light we passed popped and went dark. For at least 3 blocks. At the time it really felt like our anger was so destructive that it was affecting the world around us. My mom and I still talk about that night and wonder WTF was going on with those lights. I also had weird things happening with street lights few times. I have weird street light things as well. In the summer I ride my bike at night to avoid the heat. Every ride I would have at least on light go out as I passed. It is especially bad next to a giant church I went to as a kid. I didn't know this has happened to other people as well. Okay, this happened at my grandma's house. I was lying awake on the couch in the middle of the night when this kaleidoscope of colors and lights appeared on the ceiling and began moving around the walls. I silently watched it until it disappeared and went to sleep. I shared the living room with my sister, and my grandma slept in a chair to keep us company. Since it was dark and I hadn't heard anything, I assumed I was the only one still awake to see it. The next morning at the breakfast table, my grandma brought up the light show she had seen the night before and didn't seem to know what it was. She described what I'd seen perfectly. After she left the table, my dad and aunt both seemed very concerned that she might be losing her mind. In my little kid brain, I thought if I told them I'd seen it too, they might think the same about me, so I kept quiet about it. If it hadn't been for the fact she'd seen it too, I would have chalked it up to a number of things. But I honestly don't know what to make of it. I was driving back to high school after leaving something in my locker. I had a daydream that another classmate asked me for a ride home. In the lobby I ran into him, and he did just that. Then I drove him home. Felt super weird then. We never spoke even really before or after. Still feels weird now. This is my favorite one. I don't know why. Feels like this could happen to me. So, I think it was last year fall, and I was sitting in my house with other friend. We are Latvians. That happened in Netherlands, and I randomly started thinking about Latvian who wants to be a millionaire host for no reason. I haven't heard anything or even thinking about him last 5-6 years. Totally forgot about that he exists. And then I asked my friend if he remember him, and he said that sounds familiar but don't remember. Then I just told him, that he was host of that show. And my friend asked why. I said, just came in head. And next day I read news that he went to Netherlands with family and died on street from heart attack day before. And I would say around that time also, pretty often these things happen with me. I cannot explain. Few friends also have seen that I randomly say something for no reason and then it happens. Sorry for my English. Your English is fine. Keep practicing and you'll get it down perfectly. When I was in high school, my family lived in a house that sat about 300 feet from the road. Every morning I had a long walk down the driveway to meet the bus, and since we lived in the country, the bus came pretty early. One morning while I was walking, something that looked like a spotlight crossed the yard in front of me, sort of the opposite of a shadow. It wasn't completely dark outside, so I could see there wasn't anything flying above me, and other than the normal sounds of being outdoors, it was silent. I had forgotten about it until I read this post. So weird. Maybe a reflection from a plane flying high enough to be exposed to the early morning sunlight. I have what I call totally useless precognition. I routinely dream about mundane events. People in a room having a discussion, going to a concert, and getting dinner beforehand. A random conversation. When the events occur, I very clearly remember having the dream about it. Nothing happens. There's no event. There's no important thing. It's just that I dreamt about it months or years before. Totally useless precognition. When I was 11, I was hanging out at my friend's grandma's place for a party and we were on her dirt road playing around on bikes at like midnight because the party was still raging on. I go off a few yards into the darkness away from the only street light for about 500 feet, and out in the bushes beside the road this ball of light I'd say the size of my fist comes out of the bushes and then sinks back behind something. At first I think it's one of the other kids with some weird flashlight, but after calling out there was nothing. The way that light moved was weird to me. It was very fluid and loopy, if that makes sense. Sorta the same motion a conductor moves their pointer for music, if anyone has seen that before. I can't really find any scientific explanation, so I'll just assume it was a ghost or fairy or something. Another is when I misplaced my favorite pocket knife my dad gave me. It's bright purple and hard to miss. I always have it on ledge of where my mattress is uneven laying on the box spring, in case there's an intruder, or on my windowsill that's directly next to my bed. I could reach over and touch it close. One day it just up and disappears. I look in my usual spots and in all my bags, coats, jeans, etc. That thing was gone. Then a full week later there it was on the ledge of my bed like it never left. I never brought it up with my folks because they would call me crazy. I hope one of my family members borrowed it and placed it back where they found it, but they always ask beforehand. Another weird thing I guess. I have this ring that my mom had given to me. It used to be my late grandmother's. It was too big for me to wear on my finger, so I put it on a chain and wore it like a necklace. I remember being in class and playing with it while doing my schoolwork, and it was still around my neck the whole time. At the end of the day, when school had let out and everyone was heading home, I realized I didn't have it around my neck anymore. I panicked and ran back to class and tried retracing my steps, but never found it. I was really upset that I had lost this ring. When I had gotten home and entered my bedroom, I saw the ring and chain placed neatly on the center of my pillow. It looked as if someone has placed it there. My husband works with clients doing trauma healing type work, often via Skype/Zoom, even pre-COVID. Years ago, he had a client session so went into the living room, where he usually did his calls. I went into our bedroom and shut the door, and was going to spend the hour working on my laptop. About 20 minutes in, I suddenly got this weird skin crawling feeling out of nowhere, and looked up from my laptop, only to see a man, kinda hologram fuzzy, like there but not there, walk into my room with what looked like a gunshot wound to his head. Told my husband, wondering WTF was that I swear I saw. Ends up the woman he was working with had lost her husband 5 months prior. He was in the military and had returned from combat, had severe PTSD and eventually killed himself. And yes, by gunshot to the head. Have you ever had other experiences like that? Snuck downstairs in 7th grade cause I couldn't sleep. Stood in the kitchen for about 10 minutes watching my dad watch Star Trek. When it went to commercial I went to go back upstairs and the garage light was on. Went out and my dad was sorting recycling. Went back in and no one was there, and the TV was off. I'm 32 now and still think about it. I have two similar experiences. I still have goosebumps thinking about it. What were they? If you don't mind my asking. When I was a child I had a dream where a monster opened my closet door and chased me all the way to my parents' room. My parents said it was just a dream, but I have never sleepwalk. I saw it chase me to their room and the closet door was open, which I never opened, much less slept with it open. So I either had a sleepwalking night terror or monsters are real, and I almost died. Thanks to you, Monstropolis was powered for a whole day. A true hero. Staying at grandparents for the weekend, they're eating dinner in dining room, I'm in living room, open concept house, everyone sees each other. Power is lost, lies are out, dark as could be. Power comes back on in what seems like 1 second. Grandmother is asleep in her bedroom and my grandfather was out in the garage. It has fucked with me my whole life. 31 now, I was about 5 or 6 at the time. Sadly both have passed by now. Only Matrix situation that messed up in my life so far. I was falling easily asleep, not remembering how I did fall asleep when around that age. Could be just that. It was dark and boring. So you fell asleep and woke up after some time. A friend and me were driving at night towards a crossing. Its traffic lights were off at night and maximum speed was 50 km/h. On the left was an underpass. So we couldn't really see what comes from there. From the right, came another car into the street we were driving in. But the driver drove slow and jittery, as if he was drunk or on drugs. So, I said to me friend, slow down. Be careful, and he did. When I tried to get a look at the other driver it was impossible. It weren't tinted windows. But all I could see was pitch black. Even the street lights didn't help. Suddenly from the underpass on the left a car shot out and drove straight over the crossing with what must have been at least 150 km/h. If we didn't slow down before and instead had maintained our speed, we would have 100% collided with that guy. At this speed we would have been toast. Even now, 10 years later, every time I pass that crossing I'm asking myself if the drunk driver was some kind of guardian angel. I had a similar moment. Four cars, of which I was one, we were all doing 120 km/h in a 100, but all of us were just cruising. No racing or anything. I got this strange feeling to slow down AMD, so did the other three cars. Just after that moment a car prop going about 140-150 km/h shot between us all and in front of me as we were going around a corner with opposite camber under an underpass and onto the motorway. Anyway, I saw a gap and just aimed for it. The guy who shot past me slammed into the wall diving each side of the motorway and went up on two wheels. I thought he was going to tip over, but he came down then shot across the road. It was like time slowed down for me. I was able to anticipate what was happening and miss it by off it, even though it happened only metres in front of my car. We all stopped safely, and we got out, and berated the driver. Really weird situation. But no one got hurt. Only the guy's car.